We're here in the old bike shop here today to get a scooter ready for the first spring rides. I'm gonna use this 2003 Sportster. All the rest of them are a little old fashioned, so you guys that own those old ones, you already know what to do. This is actually for the novice that's only owned a motorcycle a year or two and really doesn't exactly know what he's got to do to get out there and ride safe. First thing we're gonna go over is the fluids. Then we're gonna go and check the battery, some of your connections, the brakes, tires, and a few other things that are essential to this. The very first thing that you need to do is to check and make sure you have the owner's manual for your particular bike. That I can't express how much you need an owner's manual. Even if you don't plan on ever working on it, you need to buy that owner's manual. You just sit down and start reading it, you'll find out more about your motorcycle than you ever will by tinkering around with it by yourself. And when we get ready to do some of these things, you'll need that owner's manual, especially for torque specifications on nuts and bolts, which are the most neglected thing on the motorcycle. And also for tire pressures, types of fluid, fluid levels, and they also have some really great maintenance tips in there. First thing we're gonna do is check all our fluids. Now, I don't know whether you winterized or had your scooter winterized. If you did, then you used a product in your gas for stabilizing, a product that's usually used is called Stable, and you add it to your gas at the end of the winter and it'll keep the moisture out of it, keep it from gelling up. And but if you didn't, take the cap off, take a good whiff of that gas and see if it smells sour. It's amazing, but gas will go sour on you, separate. The varnish in it will gum up your carburetor and plug up your filter, and then you've got more troubles than you need. Just make sure that it's got plenty of oil in it to start out with, because we're going to start the motorcycle to bring the oil up to temperature. The reason for this is make sure we got plenty of oil in there. If it seems a little low, don't worry about it. This oil is nice and clean. Anyway, you'll see the two marks on here for where your high and your low should be. If it's below that, don't worry about it too much. If your motorcycle has been sitting over the winter or for an extended period of time, there's a check ball in the oil pump that sometimes will allow oil to go down into the crankcase after sitting for a long time. The reason we want to start the engine up is not only to bring the engine oil to a operating temperature, but to also get that oil that may have got past the check valve out of the crankcase and back into the tank so we can check the proper height. Normally, if you've taken good care of your motorcycle, the last thing you did before you put it up for the winter was to service it and change the oil or have it changed. The reason for that being oil after it's ran for a while has certain particles of moisture that collects in it, and after it sits for a while, this water and oil separates and will cause rust in different spots. So if you didn't, now's a good time to get it warmed up, check that level, and make sure it comes up to the proper height. One of the fluids levels that I forgot to tell you to check earlier was your brake fluids. They're real easy to check on the newer models because they have a glow indicator on the very top, both for your front brake and your rear brake have little sight glasses that you can tell. Make sure if you are low, take it loose carefully. Do not squeeze the handle or press on the brake with the caps off, or you're gonna wind up with a mess. If you do have to add any brake fluid, don't grab some brake fluid off the shelf that you used in your 57 Chevy. It's not gonna work, or not for very long. Make sure you get DOT 5.5 brake fluid for all your newer motorcycles. For the last 20, 30 years, it's always been DOT 5. It's a higher grade. Once you use it, make sure you seal the cap very tightly, because this stuff will attract dirt. And you don't want any dust in there. Make sure there's not any dust or debris flying around if you have to add any more of your brake fluid. So I'll get into this at a later date. Check and make sure all your clutch and brakes are operating properly. Make sure that your foot brake works. And these are a lot of things you should check each time. Make sure it returns. Make sure it returns. Make sure your brake light works. Make sure you've got plenty of pressure. Roll it by hand. Step on the foot brake. Make sure it works. The last thing you want to do is roll out into traffic and find out that your brakes don't work. So, front brakes, back brakes, check the rotors and the pads, both front and back, since you've got had the back off and the bags off and everything. You can look at the brake calipers back there. When the brake pad, which is the part that squeezes on the rotor, gets less than a 16th of an inch, you need to replace them no matter what. If they're too long, you're going to start getting rivets and everything else into your rotor, and then you've got a mess. Want to go to the next important thing is the battery. Well, you already know that it started the motor. If it didn't start the motor, we're going to go to that now. So the first thing you do is, on the particular Sportster that we have here, the battery is on the left side of the motorcycle, hidden behind this case. It's real simple. There's a bolt here. Take this loose, pop it off. Cover pops off, and you will find one of two different types of batteries. You'll find most likely a sealed battery. There's no way to actually put any liquid in it whatsoever. It comes sealed from the factory, ready to go. You put a charge on it and let it go. That's what you're probably going to find in your newer motorcycle. If you have an older motorcycle or a shovel head or something, or the battery has been replaced in it before with a different brand, or I don't like to say cheaper battery because they make good batteries like this, you'll find out that there are filler caps across the top. This being a 12 volt, it has six different locations for the water for each one of their cylinders. If you will take this out, take the battery out of the motorcycle, check and inspect, because it's been banging around in there all last summer. Make sure it has no cracks in it whatsoever. If you stored it outside or in a cold area where it freezes, make sure that there's no frozen cracks in it. These will freeze and crack. When they do, they'll start dripping out, and you do not want this acid all over your motorcycle. So make sure you take it out, check it, make sure there's no leaks to it, no cracks, no rub marks where it may have been rubbing or vibrating from being loose in your battery holder. So that's your next step. Also check all your connections. This is very important. Make sure you don't see any corrosion around your negative or your positive terminals. This will cause your battery to not give all the power that it needs to the starter, and the starter is the only thing that's going to need maximum power. So check your connections here and make sure your water level's right. A lot of these you can take a flashlight and stick from the backside and see the water level in the cylinders. So there we go there. So after we've done that and we've checked the battery over, another good thing to remember is during the winter time, it's best, I always use a battery tender. Keep the battery nice and fresh all year long. A lot of people say you don't need that, but battery tenders are cheap. Batteries are expensive, so go figure. Battery tender will last for years and years and years. I've always found that batteries that come in brand new motorcycles, brand new Harleys, will last on an average 5 years. For some reason, the aftermarket batteries, even when you buy a Harley brand, it seems, only last three. Don't ask me what the difference is. I can't tell you. So anyway, make sure that battery is in good shape, fully charged, and all the connections are clean, super clean on it, so you'll have a carefree start when you push that start button. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to check out all the lights on the motorcycle. We're going to check out blinkers, turn signals, and brake stop lights. Check them out, make sure they're all working. If one's not working, check the bulb. If it's burnt out, replace it. If it's not burnt out, if the elements are still good in it, check the ground. Move the bulb around in the socket, make sure it's making a good ground. Almost 95% of your light problems are with a faulty ground or a bad ground. Very seldom is it the hot wire. Check and clean all those, make sure they're nice and visible where you can be seen out there. On this particular Sportster model, it's kind of hard to see the belt, the drive belt on here. The drive belt actually is behind all this belt guard. We're gonna take and you can see the belt through here and you can actually look at it. If you've got a center jack, which a lot of you do because it's pretty common now and they're pretty cheap, you can buy a center jack. You can actually jack this up, rotate, put it in neutral, rotate this back tire, and inspect this belt for any outside or inside wear. Depending on how old your bike is, you'll have a belt drive or a chain drive. We'll talk about the belt first. The pulley on the transmission and on here, you can inspect it. They're a little hard to inspect, so when you come to the back side here, you can see the outside of the belt. And if you have side saddlebags on, remove the saddlebags, you'll be able to see it a lot better. Check on the rounded teeth of the belt and also on the pulley. See if there's any discoloration on one side or the other of the pulley to make sure it's tracking right. That's very important. If you don't have your wheel centered up to where the belt tracks correctly, you're gonna have problems. You're gonna have premature belt wear. So check the belt over, check for proper tension. Once again, go back to step one, which is check your service manual. Your service manual will tell you how to check for your proper tension. And I always check my tension with the rider on the bike or a person on the bike, because that affects the tension in the belt from the suspension. If you happen to have an older model with a chain drive and a sprocket, once again, rotate your wheel. If you feel a rough spot in the chain, that the chains will snag a little bit and they'll get tight in some spots and loose in others. If you find this and it's happening quite a bit, you need to further tear it down and find out where that chain is clogged. You'll actually have to replace the chain. You can usually wind up replacing two chains to one sprocket is about the ratio that you go. But if you change your sprocket, you must change your chain. It's just good sense. But if you have any rough spots or kinks in the chain, replace it. That's better than having it wrap around your axle. So the next thing, while we're down there checking out our belts and chains, is the tires. You can read on the outside of your tire what the tire pressure is supposed to be. Buy you a high quality air gauge. 99 cent air gauges are exactly that, 99 cents. Check on the side of your tire for the manufacturer's suggested tire pressure. It'll tell you in your manual also that I told you to buy first. Okay, so check the air pressure. Rotate the tire and check the tread. Check for nails, foreign objects, screws, anything that might be in there that might cause you to leak. Also on the tread depth, 3/32 is as low as you can go. Don't go any farther than 3/32 because you're looking at trouble. I've run them a little bit lower, but it wasn't because I wanted to. Okay, we know how times are tight, but the tires are the only thing between you and falling down hard. So make sure you check those tires. Also on the side and in your manual, it'll tell you how to check the manufacturer's manufacturing date. And on each tire on the side has a manufacturer's date. Over 5 years and you're gonna start wondering about that tire. Also check for weather cracks and small cracks around where the tire mounts to the rim. Okay, this is real important because those weather cracks, especially on a tire, especially one that's kept outside or seen a lot of bad weather, will start forming little weather cracks in there. Then it's time to change that tire. A little bit on tire care. If you've got some Armor All or some good tire treatment, doesn't hurt to take care of those tires that way. They'll last you longer. Now we're gonna go back to step one again on your manual. One of the most neglected things on a whole bike that anybody does, and even myself, are nuts and bolts. We refer back to the owner's manual to see what the specific torque specifications are. check your axle bolts. Got to make sure they're right. Axle, front, rear, check the gas tank. They have a tendency to loosen up. Any nut and bolt that you see out there, go ahead and check it. Make sure it's snug. It's better to try and snug it up now than to try and find it laying on the road 200 miles down the road. You don't have to worry about the engine nuts and bolts too much, but just the nuts and bolts for kickstand, all your foot pegs, check all that stuff out. Take a Torx wrench, check your controls, make sure it's all snug, handlebars, everything that actually takes a beating when you're out there on the road and all the vibrations. Make sure that all your little things are snugged down, even finger tight. So there we go. Check all those nuts and bolts. Another thing you want to check for sure is your air cleaner. Check with your manual. It'll tell you how to disconnect and take apart the outside cover. On this particular model, it's just two bolts. Cover comes off, and if it's an original paper filter, check and see how it is. You can stick a flashlight in there and see how dirty it is. Wrap it on the floor. If a lot of crap comes out, it's time to change it. If it's been replaced, if you didn't buy it new and it's been replaced by, say, a K&N filter, you're going to find that there's oil all the way around the K&N filter. You can wash this out with warm, soapy water, and dry it extremely well to where it's perfectly dry, then come back with the K&N oil and lightly mist the filter. Put it back in, snug the bolts up to factory specs, and you're ready to go. Can't tell you how important the air cleaner is. So that just about takes care of our spring startup. Go out and have fun. But this is something you need to do more than each spring. I suggest that you check the belts, nuts, bolts. If you haven't got anything to do on a rainy day, go out in the garage, piddle around with your scooter, shine it up, check all those nuts and bolts. Whatever you do, ride safe.